Junior guard Cortland Muldrew has been putting on a show recently at Harber.
My teammates put me in a great position. My coaches, they put me in a great position. They trust me. So it's really just them putting that trust in me, giving me like the confidence in myself to go out there and do what I can do.
Averaging nearly 29 points per game this season. However, this is just his first season in the two shades of blue after fanning the flames of a rivalry by trading in Springdale's red and black.
I feel like I came into a better environment, people that support me better. I just want to go out there and show them what I can do and give them something to cheer about.
I wouldn't say anything to be honest, because like they don't know what we do. Like they don't know what we do behind the doors. Like they just see what we do out there on the basketball court. They don't see how much work we put in. Like we put in so much work, like on off the court. Like we just put a bunch of work, and that's what we do. When we put in work. We're number one team in the conference for a reason.
Guys above me to look up to and actually learn from. We battle every day. I have to battle against them every day in practice. Me as a freshman, that's just, it's really, really good competition to go against.
Every time you step on the floor, you got something to withhold. You got something that you better understand that everybody's trying to knock you off. You wouldn't want it any other way, all right? So let's be ready to handle that.
While the eyes of the nation are on Muldrew, he says his sights are set on the ultimate prize, bringing home a state title in March.
I want to win a state championship. That's a big goal for my team. That's what we preach every day, stuff like that. Like little things like taking charges, stuff like that, is going to win us a championship. So I think that's our main goal. Cortland Muldrew, Harber High School, number 3.
Jackson Conley on number 4 for Harber.
Alright, so introduce yourself.
My name is Marley. I'm a freshman, number 12.
I mean, we've always been close, but since we played together, it's been like we got in bond, like real, real, real close. I mean, we used to play together when we were young. Me, him, and Isaiah also played together. So yeah, we've just been creating our bond, getting to know each other better, stuff like that. But every day in practice, we're going head to head. Like we'll cuss each other out, push each other, stuff like that. But in practice, we're competing. But in games, we're brothers. Really. So. But I think us fighting in practice, stuff like that, that's just making us stronger because we both want to win. We both want to compete.
I feel like it's good. He came over and like everybody thought he was gonna be like the problem and not like be like bad over here. But he's been like really good around school. Everybody likes him. And Mar, he came over. The Benville players, they were doubting him. But he came over and like proved and put all the haters wrong, and Hayden Woods stepped up big time, and Jabari, another sophomore, stepped up big time too this year.
Hayden, help you grow your confidence for the game and go out there in the big games and play.
It's really good for me being young as a freshman coming in and having people to look up to like Cortland, Jackson, and Wood, and all the older guys to learn from and battle with during practice to make myself better and a better player. Yeah.
It feels really good. Last year I was scared at the end of the season because all our starters were basically seniors except me and Hayden. So I was like, it's going to be tough. And then Cortland came over and it just really helped us a lot. And now I feel like we're in a good state of mind. We can't get too cocky and we got to go out and do what we do and then perform every night and hopefully come out with the outcome that we want.
It's been a lot of tough days in practice. We really battle in practice. So last year in Springdale, we didn't really battle like that. But every day at Harbor, we're battling, we're going at each other's heads, we're getting into arguments, stuff like that. Like, we really want it, we're competing. And I feel like that's why we're one of the top teams in the state right now.
To Neosho in Missouri. Talk about that tournament, you know, 3 days in a row, going through that tournament, winning the championship. What was it like to do that with this team?
It was really fun. I feel like we got a lot better. And it was challenging at first because we had to play with a different ball, but I feel like we still overcame that, and we just came together, and we played a lot better since that tournament.
Ample in this tournament, never been here before, at least I haven't as a head coach. Ample this thing, trophy, we'll have a good day out tomorrow, and then we can focus and lock it on top. Now, that being said, starts every night with our defense. You gotta do up here, lock in, get focused, that's what it's gonna take. That's exactly what it's gonna take. We'll make shots, I think, better than we did last night. We're gonna make three threes. Never, ever has that happened, and we still won't come. All right, tonight, lock in on your shooting, concentrate, knock the threes down, we'll be fine, all right? That's it, accomplishment. Don't think they're saying you're here. With a lot of joy and sense of accomplishment, if they beat us, what their Saturday, what their Sunday practice will be like, all right? If they knock the number two team off, every time you step on the floor, you've got something to withhold. You've got something that you better understand that everybody's trying to knock you off. You wouldn't want it any other way, all right? So let's get ready to handle that.
How you feeling?
Said some, talk with, but they still ain't saying nothing. We gon' trap the down till the feds come.
Run it up,
huh?
What she say?
And 50s, can't swap a dime. Really didn't think before I did it.
Nope.
Make it make sense.
Please.
Luckily, I was on point with the last. Kept my receipt.
I see what
you're saying.
Go. Forever I rip, put the set on the chain. I'm thugging you, I already know how I came. Yeah, you got money, but be lying. I I can get you touched, put you in a blender, I can get you slush. I see the comments, the real talk cause she spoke on the business.
I'm a pure slasher.
It means a lot. Like I said, it goes a lot of work into it. Shooting every day with my dad, my brother, people who just helped me. But it started when I was younger. I used to play in the Boys and Girls Club League. They made a rule where I couldn't play one half because I was scoring too much. So yeah, I've just always been that type of scorer, just always have that battle mentality.
I feel like my work ethic is good. I work with Tyler Garrett a lot after practice, and then on the weekends, on Sundays, I work with Deshaun Stark, my summer ball coach, and he's really helped me a lot with my process. Shooting the ball is the main reason because of him, because we stayed long hours after working on it.
What you want to say, man?
How much the rest to have?
Huh?
How much the rest to have?
Ooh. What is it?
You have 16 right now.
Oh, how much do I finish with?
Yeah.
A little 30. You know what I'm saying? Gotta get 30.
Got it.
24 by the end of the quarter.
Yeah.
They told me I got you in my bed. I'm gonna be strange, nothing at all.
This is heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. We forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Now the keys to the game from Coach Deffenbaugh. You got to rebound, you got to take care of the ball, and you got to have some better shot selection in this ball game. And we see an interesting thing happen already. Coach Deffenbaugh throws a curveball to begin with. Jackson Conley not starting in the ball game.
Yeah, you know, I'd like to see how that impacts the rest of the game. I wonder how long he's going to be out. Obviously, don't know the reason why.
We do not. Going inside, Cortland Muldrew gets the back basketball. It was not going to be long before Muldrew. Muldrew, they give it out inside to Wilhelm, goes inside, gets the bucket. Something that we talked about a little bit, the post play. Washington shoots the gap, steals the ball, gives it to Muldrew. Muldrew looking to go inside, puts it up and good. Portland, Muldrew. Now to Muldrew. Muldrew, deep three, and someone like that is why this Wildcat team runs. Home, but Conley there to disturb the play. Muldrew pulls up, mid three-point, no good. Conley going inside, puts up the layup, gets it to fall, and here come the Wildcats when they stay. Not here for it. Jabari Washington pulls from three. Does not get the ball. Marley! Dunk time! Marley says, I'm here, folks. Javen Williams gets the three-point basket. Cortland Muldrew goes inside for the basket.
On Tuesday, school districts across five countries announced they would be closed due to inclement weather.
Just into our newsroom in the last hour, several schools already calling a snow day for tomorrow. Some of the major ones to report, Fort Smith was just added, along with Fayetteville, Springdale, Bentonville, and Rogers school districts are all out tomorrow.
I think we play Springdale for sure. It's gonna be a movie, but yeah, I think I keep scoring the ball, keep helping everybody out, keep getting my teammates involved. Everybody will keep cheering, so just want to make everybody happy. Sitting in, he's treating me like a son from the very start. Like, I can feel the love right there. I feel very, very way more loved here than I did at Springdale. But I gave it all to Coach Devin Ball. He showed me very love. He showed me love from the start, taking me in. A kid who just beat him last year, but taking me in as a son, and that was real big for me.
Yeah, but you guys are still close friends. What would you say about, you know, was it hard leaving him over there and then coming over here and not knowing that you would be able to play with Roy anymore?
I mean, yeah, it was hard. I mean, it was like, we've been playing together since we were real young, so us teaming up in high school, that was always something we talked about, but I mean, I had to do what's best for me to get away from over that situation over there, but yeah.
Last question. Obviously, the transfer over from a school where everybody claimed that they cared about you and loved you, but when they all would lose, there was one guy they had to blame, and it was always you. Now that you're here and there's love and there's acceptance around you, what makes you want to win from this
one? You said it, like the love and acceptance. Really, I feel like everyone over here likes me. Everyone treats me cool, everyone's fair. But I feel like they all support me. I feel like they think I'm a good player. And everyone's real supportive. The teachers, principals, nurses, everyone congratulates me on everything. So I really think it's love over here. Like, no one's going to, like, point me out if we lose or something like that. I feel like everyone's genuine and everyone really cares about me.
just feel like just keep coming out and supporting us because we love it. We adore it. We love it a lot. We've played better when we have more people out watching us. And I just feel like if y'all just stay with us and stay, enjoy the ride, we're going to come out with the win and we all going to be happy.
Season as number one ranked Harber takes on number three ranked Fayetteville. And for a deeper look at this marquee matchup, we turn to Robin Hearn.
Top talent. Top in the state. 5-0 in conference play. The Harber and Fayetteville boys basketball matchup on Saturday is already gearing up to be one to watch.
It would be great first year here. I mean, even when people found out I was transferring here, everyone was like, we can win the state championship. And people didn't know that we're going to be this good, but I feel like everyone thinks we have a chance this year.
So good is their depth. For the Wildcats, all eyes have been on top recruit Cortland Muldrew. Head coach Tommy Deffenbach says, but watch out for two other key playmakers, Jackson Conley.
He leads us in every statistical category but one. Cortland outscores. He's our leading scorer. Jackson Conley does everything else that stats don't always show.
And Hayden Wood.
I call him the quiet assassin.
Side, this matchup will also come down to energy, something the Bulldogs feel they have an advantage in.
You know, we've got to play well. We've got to, you know, be able to defend their actions.
As for the other side, the Wildcats believe victory comes down to executing the basics.
In this conference, winning on the road is very, very difficult. I mean, when you continue to rebound, you don't turn the ball over, and you get to the free throw line, and you're shooting at a high clip like we can, you can win games on the road.
But the one thing they do have in common, both teams are coming in ready to win.
We know it's going to be a challenge. We know what we're up against.
We've got ourselves one of the best games you can possibly watch in high school basketball in the state of Arkansas here tonight.
Yeah, you got two of the best teams in the state squaring off here tonight here in Fayetteville, Arkansas with your Harber Wildcats and your Fayetteville Bulldogs. And it's going to be a high tempo, fast pace, a lot of scoring, a lot of great defense, a lot of crowd involvement. I can already see the crowd getting ready. The student section here is packed across from us, but it's going to be a fun game.
Thank you.
with the assist by Haney.
Jabari Washington, not in the best of health, leaving the court right now with head trainer Lauren Ward.
Thank you.
Scott will check in the ballgame for Muldrew. This is the battle for the one seed, and it looks like Fayetteville will take it. That is the end of the ballgame, 77-65, a 12-point win for the Bulldogs, and a decisive game towards the standings. The Bulldogs take over the one seed from the Wildcats, no longer two undefeated teams in the league.
Nope, no longer. And